interject, under the new rules on the registration and sale of pre-need plants, Section 16 of the Securities Regulation Code, they have definition of terms here. This is a 2001 issuance from the SEC, which defines trust fund as follows. Means a fund set up from plant holder payments, separate and distinct from the paid up capital of a registered pre-need company. That's very clear. Established with a trustee under a trust agreement approved by the commission to pay for the benefits as provided in the pre-need plan. So this is already existing. It only talks of payment for the benefits as provided in the pre-need plan. So if there are any other payments other than benefits, then it's not included. It would be in violation of the definition of trust fund. So payment to a creditor is not for benefits. Payment to Mr. Sobrepeña is not a benefit. So it is a violation of the definition of trust fund. And then it also states what are the uses of the trust fund. It's all very clear here. But investment of the trust fund, Rule 17 of the new rules and the registration and sale of pre-need plants under Section 16 of the Securities Regulation Code, investment of the trust funds, what are the allowable investment? Number one, fixed income instruments, and then enumerated government securities. Real estate is not a government security. Savings and time deposit is not. Commercial papers registered with the commission with a credit rating of one, it is not. So it does not fall under this. Letter D, direct loans to corporations which are financially stable, profitable, so it is not. So under fixed instrument, this transaction, the purchase of shares of stocks, does not fall under fixed instruments. Second, mutual funds duly registered with the commission. It is not a mutual fund, it is not Magellan, it is not whatever, so it is not. Number three, equities. Investment in equities shall be limited to stocks listed on the main board of a local stock exchange. So here, it is very obvious that we're talking here of equities of real estate, but these are not equities listed on the main board of a local stock exchange. So, hindi rin yun. Number four, real estate. Hindi rin real estate. Share of stocks of a real estate company is not real estate. It is only the share of that real estate company, unlike what was revealed by Mr. reported by Mr. Marcelo before, that now the change is to actual real estate. Of course, that is now acceptable, but that's still subject to appraisal, because even if it's real estate, there shall be a TCT, and it will be appraised every 3 years by a licensed real estate appraiser accredited by the Philippine Association of Real Estate Appraisers. So it cannot just be simple TCT. The valuation is still very critical here. So, Mr. Chairman, it's very obvious that even without the proposed amendment, we have here a clear case of a violation of Rule 17 of Section 16 of the new rules on the registration and sale of pre-need plants under Section 16 of the Securities Regulation Code. May we know the comment of the SEC with respect to our humble observations, Mr. Chairman?
You're right, Congressman. about these rules. In fact, these rules have been further strengthened by this SEC memorandum circular number 4.
So this transaction entered into by the trustee for the trust fund is does not fall under any of these enumerations. So what is now the course? What is now the responsibility of the trustee back here, Philippine Veterans Bank? This is something that we just say charge of experience, or shouldn't they be solvently also explained? Or shouldn't the SEC confront the Philippine Veterans Bank? In this particular case, Mr. Chairman, I would like to request that we get the names of I understand it's a Philippine Veterans Bank, but who was the trustee officer responsible for this trust fund at that time? And if this required the approval of the board of the Philippine Veterans Bank, or only the board of advisors of the trust fund, because I understand from the prospectus of the screening plans that they show the members of the board of directors of the company. At the same time, they also show the members of the, I don't know what you call this, board of advisors of the trust fund. I beg your pardon, Mr. President.
It's called trust committee.
It's a trust committee. And my recollection is that these are supposedly very respectable members of Philippine society.
Mr. Chairman, can I make an observation?
May I just before Mr. Marcelo, may I also, so we should get the names of these officers, Mr. Chairman, what you call it, the trust committee. They should be answerable for this, for the Philippine Veterans Bank, the one directly responsible for the management of the trust fund, and who was the one who recommended the approval of this transaction, presumably to the board of the Philippine Veterans Bank, if it went up to that level, or to the president of the Philippine Veterans Bank, if it was only up to that level.
You're right, Ombudsman Boyles. Maybe
that's also but also the SEC officers responsible for the implementation of Rule 17.
Not only Veterans Bank, but all trustee banks should be required